Hey guys, welcome back. So I've been using Google Calendar as a daily planner to organize my life for the past 5 years. And in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you exactly how to use Google Calendar effectively with 6 advanced tips and tricks to organize your life and become more productive. I wanna start on my laptop and I'm going to calendar.google.com. You can download the app on your iPhone or Android, but everything I show you on the desktop is going to be very similar to the app on your mobile. So let's get started. On the top right corner of the screen, you're gonna see a drop down that you can select based on the day, week, month, year, and schedule. Now this is going to be how you view your calendar. If I want to have the weekly view, I'm gonna select the week or simply hit W on my keyboard, and it's going to show me our weekly view. We can also scroll through different weeks here by clicking on the right and left arrows. So if you want just to focus on today and see your daily breakdown, you can select day or hit D on your keyboard to have a daily view. So the keyboard shortcuts are first letter of every word, D for the day, W for week, M for month, and Y for the year. Now the schedule is not going to show you any day without any event or task. Basically it's going to show you every single task or event or appointment you have as a list. So I normally like to use the weekly or daily view, and I rarely use the other options. Just a quick tip here, if you want to select a specific date range, you can use your mouse and highlight it from a date to any date, like a 3 days range, and view your selection easier. Now let's talk about the main stuff, how to create and add events to my Google Calendar. So if you single click on any date, you'll see this pops up and you have the option to save it as an event, task, reminder, or appointment. I mentioned single click earlier because if you double click, it's gonna open the event automatically instead of letting you choose from 4 different options. So let's go ahead and give this event a name. We are gonna enter meeting with Ali. Now if it's an all day event, we can click on the date and select all day, but in this case we are gonna select from 3 to 5 p.m. which is going to be 2 hours. Right next to that you're gonna see something that says does not repeat. Now this is about the things you repeatedly do, like your habits. You can create a recurring event for your morning routine, gym, coffee break, and much more. For example, personally I use this for my morning run and shower, my gym sessions every night, and some other things that happen at the end of every month, like getting my monthly sales report. For example, if you go to the gym on the event days, you can choose Monday, Wednesday, and Friday and click done. You can add guests if you want, and you can easily enter their email to add other people. You can add Google Meet video conferencing, so when you click on it you can see that it gives us our Google Meet link that we can share with others. Now if you want, you can add a location. This way at the event date you can easily pull up the address from your phone, which makes it easier. The next thing is to select the calendar you want to add this event to. Now if you're new to Google Calendar, you probably only have one calendar, but if you have different calendars you can select the drop down menu and select the calendar and select the color you want it to be. Right next to that we have the busy or free options. Now if you let others book appointments with you, you want to make sure to leave it busy so your clients won't be able to pick this time. Finally we have the option to add a notification to our event, like 10 minutes or half an hour, and we can add multiple notifications if we want. Now if we click on save, you can see it says would you like to send invitation emails to your guests. So if we click on yes, it's going to notify everyone we added to this event, but for now we are going to select don't send. Now if you want to edit or delete an event, it's as simple as selecting the event and clicking on edit or the delete button. Now let's talk about how to create a group calendar and share it with a team. So at the bottom left corner we have my calendars. If we click on the plus button, you can see a couple of different options. We can subscribe to a calendar, we can create a new calendar, we can browse calendars, we can get a calendar from a URL. Finally we can click on import and import a calendar from a file on our computer. Now let's go ahead and create a new calendar. So let's give our new calendar calendar a name, and we're gonna call it work. We can add a description if you want, and we can select a time zone, which usually Google chooses the right one for you. Finally, when you're ready, you can click on create calendar. Now, once you create a new calendar, you can see it here on the left side, and if we click on it, we can change our calendar setting. We can auto accept invitations, we can change the access permissions for events by making them available to public, we can add and share our calendars with others, we can add event notifications like a notification or an email 10 minutes before our events, and finally we can remove and delete our calendar. There are so many things you can do here. I'm not gonna go over every detail, but if you guys have any questions, make sure to comment below and I'll try my best to help you out. Now, if you want to share your Google Calendar, you can click on the three dots right next to your calendar and click on settings and sharing. If you scroll down, you can see that under access permissions, we have the get shareable link. And if you click on it, Google Calendar is going to give us your link. We can copy it and send it to anyone we want, or simply we can add them on their share with specific people. So that's the basics of Google Calendar. Now, if you want to get more into advanced things, we can add different apps or extensions or add-on to our Google Calendar. So if we go to get add-ons on the right side, we're gonna go to the Google Workspace Marketplace. As you can see, there are thousands of useful add-ons like Zoom and Microsoft Meeting. But if we click on this three line icon, you can see that Google Calendar is going to show us the editor's choice for work from anywhere for productivity and collaboration tools. We have business essentials apps, we have apps to discover, we have the most popular as well as the top rated tools. We can also have them based on the categories. And finally, we have the add-ons that work with different Google products. All right, now that you know the basics of Google Calendar, let's get into the more advanced tips and tricks you can choose to boost your productivity and time management. All right, Google Calendar tip number one, you can add invisible events that only you can see. So when you create a new event, at the end of it, make sure to change the setting from busy to free and set the default visibility to private and click save. For example, if you have a short coffee break that you want to remind yourself of, but let the public know that you're available, you can create a new event that only you can see. Google Calendar tip number two, you can get your daily agenda in your inbox. So for those people who don't have the habit of checking your schedule for the next day, this is going to be a game changer. All you have to do is to go to your Google Calendar setting menu, and under other notifications, you can see the daily agenda. Just select email and you're gonna receive your daily agenda in your inbox every morning at 5 a.m. Google Calendar tip number three, if you don't like these default color options of your calendar, you can go to colorhunt.co and find a color palette that you like. You can simply copy the hex codes and in Google Calendar, click on add custom color and replace the hex code and click save. Google Calendar tip number four is about a super useful extension called Button for Google Chrome. So once you add and pin this extension to your browser, you're gonna see that not only it shows you how many hours are left until your next event, but also you can have a quick overview of your calendar and go to your virtual meetings with just one click. Google tip number five is about keyboard shortcuts, which makes everything so much easier for you. But make sure to go to your settings and enable keyboard shortcuts. You can press Control and the question mark and you're gonna have this list of them. So here are some shortcuts I personally use every day. So to navigate faster, you can use C to create an event, T for today, P for previous, and N for next. Now to change your view, you can use D for day, W for week, M for month, and Y for the year view. Now the final tip is to use your mouse. You can actually highlight any dates you want with your mouse and you're gonna have the view of those highlighted dates here. Another useful tip is that instead of creating a new event and changing the times manually, you can hold your mouse and drag it for any specific time frame you want and you're gonna have it. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. Now if you guys have any question, make sure to comment below and I'll try my best to help you out. If you found this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure to watch one of these videos next. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.